Hi guys and welcome to Red Fans. Today I wanted to do kind of a mashup. I mean, I wanted to watch a video with Claudia Winkleman in it. I wanted to see Rod Gilbert, which you guys have mentioned in the videos, and I haven't seen anything from him yet. And I also felt like I wanted to watch Dave Mitchell, which I have seen before, just judging everyone and not actually telling the story. So I wanted to check that out. I found the perfect video for it. It has all of them. And it's, this is mine. It's gonna be about Tony. Is he David's Lego play pal, Claudia's handyman, or Rod's bandmate? It's gonna be a fun one. I know for a fact it's gonna be a fun one. Also, before starting the video, I wanted to let you guys know that I finally have the community post thingy in YouTube. So you can expect either polls or just different comments and different topics to try and discuss and maybe get to know a little bit better, get to know each other a little bit better. So yeah, with that being said, let's go.
Please welcome this week's special guest, Tony.
Tony Montana.
Right, let's start with you, Claudia. What is Tony to you?
This is Tony. He's my builder. He drove for over an hour to come to my house to fix my TV, and it turned out all I needed to do was change the batteries in the remote control.
Rod, how do you know Tony?
This is Tony, and we played in a band together. We both played guitar, except only his was plugged in, because I can't play a note.
Okay. David, what is your relationship with Tony?
He smiled at that.
And I regularly go round to his house to play with his Lego.
So,
can I say that I want David's story to be true so bad, just because I love Lego? I just want it to be true so bad.
There we have it. Claudia's helpful handyman, Rod's musical mate, or David's play pal. Lee's team, where would you like to begin?
Okay, let's start with Claudia. Yes. How do you know him?
He built my house.
Out of Lego? Is it a combined story?
What happened is my telly didn't work, and so I thought...
I got it. Did he put the television in the house?
Yeah. Yes.
So he built this from scratch, as in it was foundations up?
Well, no, but he did the other stuff.
What other stuff?
No, the painting. Help me.
I think I'm gonna.
You know, the other stuff.
The painting.
The television wasn't working.
Correct. You thought,
I'll call my builder.
That's what happened.
Why did you think the builder is responsible for the television?
I thought he would know about things falling off. I've got an unstable roof.
You've got an unstable mind.
She does have an unstable mind, and I'm glad he pointed that out, because I haven't said a word. And it's just because it's Claudia, and I don't know. I thought it was gonna be like easier in this setting, but apparently she's a master in this.
I've got an unstable roof.
You've got an unstable mind.
Why are you clapping?
Because it's true.
The telly didn't work. The little puffin baby, what's his? Yeah,
what,
he wants
what,
to watch
what
the
do you
telly.
Mean, little puffin
what is
baby?
Puffin? The puffin.
Yeah. Stop talking to me.
I thought you said that you wanted to watch the telly.
I did.
But then what is Puffin doing?
I only want to watch what he wants
Who
to watch.
Who in the love of God is the Puffin? Whose mind is the worst? Claudia's or yours? She said, I wanted to help out the little Puffin. And instead of going, what's the Puffin going to do with it? You went, well, hang on, who wanted to watch the telly, you or the Puffin? Doesn't matter where he wants to watch the telly.
This is so wrong, man.
Went, no problem, because...
Tell us what the Puffin is doing in the house and I'm not moving on!
No, that's not his real name. He's called Arthur, but...
Who's Arthur?
Your child!
Your son! That's all I wanted! Did you go to the Rod Gilbert School of Explanation?
Let's move this on. OK, then he arrives and he gets to the house.
Yeah.
He comes in and what happens?
And I say something must have fallen off the roof, Tony.
Meaning the aerial or the dish.
But didn't you see that little red light in the bottom right-hand corner that wasn't green?
Interesting.
Did he fix it straight away?
Interesting.
Or did he not have the tools? Watch his face.
No.
Did he have to nip to see his mate Kevin, who's got the right tools, who lives 4 days away?
He just got the remote. It was like magic.
Okay.
And he flicked this thing.
Right.
This is the killer question that will decide whether she's telling the truth. Did he charge you?
No.
He's not a builder.
Well, there we are. Now, who would you like to question next?
OK, so, Rod. Sorry, reminded of your fact.
I can't even remember his name.
I'm
bluffing.
Right.
This is Tony.
Right.
We played in a band together.
Oh,
we
yes.
both played guitar, but his only his was plugged in because I can't play.
So
enough.
You can't play.
What was the band called?
It was a long time. Muck Spreader.
And where did you get the name from?
Two of the band were like farmers. It's rural West Wales.
Why were you part of the band then? If you couldn't play and you weren't singing?
Because Tony was the lead singer and guitarist, and
as you see him now,
why that's the kind of charisma he brought to the stage.
Why were you in the band?
That's what I'm coming to. That's what
you
I'm
were
saying.
There for charisma.
No, Tony was. This is what he was like as a lead front man.
Surely he didn't put his arms behind his back when he was playing the guitar.
No, he had a guitar. He had a guitar in front of him.
Yeah.
But in all other ways, that is exactly what
dressed
he was
in
like.
A seat.
Right. And he was that dull and uncharismatic at
right.
the front of the
that.
So boring was he.
That
at the front.
Is not. We're not doubting that. What we're doubting is the fact that he thought you could help that situation.
Right. He saw me dancing kind of on the dance floor in a barn dance thing, and they thought, we need a front man because I was just so dull.
So you were like the Bez.
The Bez.
I was exactly like the Bez, but with a guitar.
And I was going to say, what kind of music did you play? But you didn't. What kind of music didn't you play?
the band was a sort of punky, rocky sort
can
of.
You, can you.
Punky, rocky, is that how you introduced it? Johnny Rotten.
Punky, rocky.
I'm going to do some punky, rocky music.
Can you do it?
Find the Muck Spreaders.
Can you do
I am the Antichrist. I'm not. I'm a farmer. All our songs have the word muck in the title.
like what?
Like, hey, hey, we're the Muck Spreaders. Muck Ado About Nothing.
You did Shakespeare plays as well. Oh, I see now it's all making sense. And now, ladies and gentlemen, this punk rock band would now like to perform a piece from Shakespeare. But he won't be speaking, he's not plugged in, he'll mime it.
Okay. So, what about David?
Just standing there.
David, this is Tony, and you go around to his house to play Lego, is that what you're saying?
Why would you play Lego at Tony's house?
He's got a lot of Lego.
Can I say at this point,
on this mention of Lego
just
being the BBC, there are other children's building blocks available. They're not as good, but there are, there are others. Sorry, carry on.
Yes, absolutely.
How often do you go around to his house and play with Lego?
I suppose it must be.
He just said that to kind of erase the unpaid promotion they're giving Lego. And Lee Mag is like, hey, you playing with Lego? Just because. It's really interesting to see Lee Mag asking the questions, because his wit and the fast pace that he has, it makes it difficult for the other team.
I suppose it must be once every 2 or 3 weeks.
How long is a session?
Oh, 2 or 3 hours.
And do you freeform, or have you got a kit that you follow the instructions?
We're building a castle.
Are you?
A model of a castle.
So this castle, is it an exact replica of your house, or is it?
No, it's supposed to look like the Tower of London.
So how big is it going to end up being? It's obviously big, isn't it?
When it's finished, I think it'll be, I would say, roughly the size of one of these circles here.
Wow, and how long is that going to take?
As big as that?
Yeah. It's going to be, it's big.
Do you have different sections that you work on, or do you work on the same section at the same time?
What we've largely done is completed the White Tower. And now we're trying to work out the footprint, if you see what I mean, of the curtain wall.
Quick question. Are you still married?
yes, I am.
You see what I mean?
I know him because I made a documentary. And I met him doing that.
What was the documentary called?
The documentary was called The Pursuit of Youth. It was about people who are into, you know, childish things as adults.
And they got you to host that?
Yes.
Seems appropriate.
How did you approach this sort of Lego building? Did everyone believe you? So you told your wife, you said, I'm going to go and build Lego at Tony's house, and everything was fine, and that was all...
She seemed to believe me.
Has Tony got a wife?
I can answer that.
Yes, Tony does have a wife.
What is the name of the person who started Lego?
I don't know.
Nor do I, so...
Then why would he ask the question?
So, Lee's team, is Tony Claudia's helpful handyman, Rod's musical mate, or David's play pal?
Well, David's play...
Okay. I'm going to say that... I really want to believe that he's David's play pal. Because I would really love to have someone that enjoys Lego as well and just go at it building stuff. That's just me. About the different stories they told. Claudia doesn't seem to be telling the truth. I just have a gut feeling that she's not telling the truth. Rod is making me doubt. Because I know bands that have like a mascot, and he would fit that role of a mascot. But I'm going to go with David. If I lose, I lose. This game has taught me that I don't know anything. So, yeah. If I lose, I lose. I'm going to go with David.
I played this game long enough to know that if he was to put in the phrase, I was making a telly show, that would be a risk. Are you following his career? I'm not. Anybody here following David's career?
I feel like I saw the trailer for it.
Don't say that even as a
trailer. I feel like I saw the trailer.
That was trailers. This week on Pursuit of You. How's your wife, Tony? Join us next week on Pursuit of You.
That sounds like something that could happen.
I think you're wise. You're clever. You would have thought this through, I feel.
You think Claudia is wise and clever?
Wise and clever. There's two.
Have you ever seen her on the television? Or met her?
No, but I think you have good initiative. You have very good initiative.
So who do you think it is, Jamie, if you don't think it's Claudia?
I mean, I do think it's Claudia, maybe. I don't know.
What?
Well, now it's just changed.
You now think it's Claudia.
I think it's Claudia.
I think it's Rod.
Oh.
You're wrong.
Oh, well, in that case.
No, you could be
wrong. Don't you change your mind.
No,
he's already done this.
I'm easily susceptible. I want it to be David.
I
think
it to
it's Claudia.
David.
I'm going
David.
With Rod.
No.
Wow. Wow.
What's it going to be? We need you.
She's in the documentary, David.
David.
You better
all right.
Seen this
Tony.
Documentary.
Would you please reveal your true identity?
My name is Tony, and I drove to Claudia's to fix it.
Oh, come on, man. No, man.
Yes, Tony,
like seriously?
Claudia's helpful handyman. Thank you very much, Tony.
This is just frustrating. This is frustrating. I'm gonna stop playing this. Like seriously. I'm gonna stop playing this. I've seen 3 videos already from Claudia. I haven't even taken this thing off. I've seen 3 videos from Claudia. One of them was asking if she, when she met people, if she tried to associate them with animals. Spoiler alert, I didn't get that one. The second video was the possession one with Yoshi. Spoiler alert again, I didn't get that one either. Didn't get that one either. And now, man, what am I gonna do with Claudia? I just don't get it. I don't get it. Guys, I'm gonna be leaving the video there for today. Remember, as always, like, comment, share, subscribe, remember notification bell so that you receive alerts every time a new video pops up, and that's gonna be all. Have a good one.